Welcome to the Paul Douglas Red Paved Trail. Good afternoon, everyone. I am coming to you today from the town of Hoffman Estates, Illinois. It is at this point where I'm going to ride the Paul Douglas Red Paved Trail, which is this trail here that goes around this forest preserve. It's pretty loud right here with car traffic. This back over here is I-90, so we're pretty close to I-90 at this point. The Red Paved Trail is about 7.2 miles long, and very much like the Poplar Creek Trail that I just did, the Red Paved Loop. Incidentally, we're only about 10 minutes away by car from that location, to put that in perspective. I have previously ridden this loop once, although it was before I added music and telemetry to my videos, so I was running short on time today. I had time for a couple quick loops before I headed back, so I decided to check this out. That way I could put out a new video that has some telemetry. According to the map here, we are right here at mile marker zero. Now, I believe the last time I rode this trail, I started this way over here, so I ran it clockwise. So today, I'm gonna run it counterclockwise and just go this way first. Also, according to this, there's a black trail that's 2.7 miles long. So I've never ridden this portion of trail, so what I'm gonna do is again, starting from here, we're gonna go this way up, come all the way up here. Instead of going back down, I'm gonna go up this black trail all the way to where it ends at this old Stover Trailhead, and then turn around, make my way back down, and then finish the red portion until we get back to the car here. All right, let's check this trail out. And we're off. So if you've noticed, I'm wearing the same shirt I did on the last ride. That's because I'm doing the two loops today. They're both pretty short, and I don't have time to really drive anywhere far today as we have the grandkids coming over in the afternoon. So we're about 10 minutes by car to the Poplar Creek Trail system, which is that red paved trail that I just finished. So it's very close proximity to this trail here. Immediately on starting this trail, the big downside is all the traffic noise from 90 over here. But we're going to get a little further away from that, and hopefully the noise won't be so bad. Okay, so we went past that long bridge there. It's a pedestrian bridge. It connects up to this trail. It's not part of this trail, but since it's so long and relatively new looking, I figured I'd just get a shoot down there to see what I can see and then turn around and make my way back. Okay, they have a nice little cutout here, so you could stop and look around without actually being in the way of anybody. So I'm a big fan of that. Looks like we could see medieval times over this way. Incidentally, if you're a fan of medieval times and you haven't been to the Bristol Renaissance Fair, the Renaissance Fair just started again yesterday, so it goes for the next 9 weeks. I highly recommend it. We were there at opening day yesterday, had a ton of fun. I'll definitely be checking out the Ren Fair at least a couple more times before the end of the season. It sucks that it's only 9 weeks of the year. As always, when given an opportunity, let's take a moment to recognize Old Glory. Definitely no breeze, but standing proud nonetheless. Okay, so we're in the top left corner of the map. So, to get back to the car, we have to go this way, but as I discussed at the beginning of the video, I've never been down this way. This is the black paved trail, so I'm gonna take it to where it ends at that trailhead and then turn around and come back. Okay, so that black paved trail looks like it ends here at the old Stover Trailhead. Looks like this is Palatine Road here. Looks like I see a hiking area only sign over this way. I don't know if bikes are allowed this way. But this is Palatine Road here. There's a parking lot. As you can see, it's there's only got one car in it, but they have several open spots. And let's check out that map. Okay, so a quick map update here at the old Stover Trailhead. Again, we started here, mile marker 0 or 7.2, depending on how you look at that. We ran the loop up this way, and then we got off of the red trail, the red paved trail here, got on the black paved trail. We took that all the way up to right here. That's where we are now. Now, it looks like just this way over here where I said there were hiking trails, there's a Crab Tree Nature Center here, it looks like. I don't see any other trails in this area, so we're just gonna turn around, make our way back. So while I prefer to ride around like a woodsy area as opposed to right next to a major street like Algonquin Road, you could tell that this portion of the trail is definitely neglected. I mean, it's obviously passable and it's not incredibly bad, but you could tell it's neglected. Before I took off, I wanted to add that it looks like from where we started, it's 8.6 miles to get to this current location. So all we have left to do now is head back down this black paved trail and then make our way back to the red paved trail and then back to the car. Okay, so we're back at the trail intersection where we broke off. This is the original way we came from. Then we went back this way on the black paved trail. So now we're gonna head back to the car heading this way. So just so you could see here, the loop is just basically this right here. And what we did was go all the way up and then turned around, made our way back. So now we're just gonna do the little piece at the end. We've made it back to mile marker 0.0 or 7.2, depending on which way you went. The bike says the total mileage was 13.6 miles with the little extension. I rode on that bridge and then, you know, also doing the black paved trail all the way up and back. So it is a good loop, although a little short for my liking. But I guess if I wanted to extend it, you do have that option. Taking the black trail will add about 5.5 miles to it, so that makes it a little longer. But again, we're only about 10 minutes by car to the forest preserve that I was just at, the Poplar Creek one that I did that loop at. So if you're able to take your bike by car, then I would just, if I wanted more riding, I would just get the bike all ready to go and then drive over there and then do that loop. So let me know what you think of the trail in the comments below. If you've ridden this loop before and you have a favorite part of this, definitely let me know where it is. I'll definitely be riding this again. It's not incredibly far from me. As always, if you guys enjoy this content, please be sure to share, like, and subscribe. It definitely helps the channel grow. So that's all I have for the Paul Douglas Red Paved Loop. I'll catch you on the next ride.
Do you have a trail recommendation for me? Let me know in the comments below.